So in other words, this input is twice as big as this area. Okay, in this video, we'll compare the traditional trig functions and the hyperbolic trig functions. And I know some of you guys might not have seen this yet, but it's okay, because I will first review the traditional ones with you guys, and then we will see the connection between the traditional ones and the hyperbolic ones. So be sure you watch the whole video, so that's how you can see the connection, and that's how you can get the enjoyment of learning mathematics. And before we start, I just want to thank Brilliant.org for sponsoring this video. If you're looking for a place to learn more about math, or maybe to get ahead in your calculus classes, Brilliant.org is an excellent place for you guys to go. Be sure you guys go check them out. They have a lot of interesting courses, and they are decided in an interesting and challenging way, so you guys won't be bored. Courses in calculus, number theory, discrete math, etc. So, you know, the list is there. Anyway, if you guys are also interested to sign up for the annual premium subscription, you guys can also use the link brilliant.org/blackpenredpen, and that's one of the best ways for you guys to support my channel as well. Thank you guys so much on that. Alright, so traditional trig functions. It's based on the unit circle, and the equation for the unit circle is x squared plus y squared equals 1. And we know, well, if we pick a point on the unit circle, let me just put it right here for example. And one of the things we can do is, we can first just kind of measure the angle from the positive x-axis to this point right here, right? So you have to see how big this angle is. And I will just call this angle to be t. And once we have this angle, we know that the x-coordinate of this point is just cosine t, and the y-value is just sine t. And you might be wondering, why don't I use theta? You will see why. Anyway, so this is pretty much it. And because this right here is the x value, this right here is the y value, if you plug this in, you automatically have that identity. Cosine squared t plus sine squared t equals to 1, isn't it? Right? X squared plus y squared is equal to 1. That's pretty much it. So that's it. That's good. All right? Now, for the hyperbolic ones, instead of using a circle, we will just be using a hyperbola. And we'll be using the open right, that branch, okay? So the one that we'll be using is x squared minus y squared equals to 1. And that's pretty much it. And you see, I just changed the plus to a minus. Another thing, though, is that I want x to be greater than or equal to 1, technically speaking, okay? And let's draw a picture real quick. And of course, x squared minus y squared is equal to 1. It's a left and right branch. But since I just want to look at the right-hand side, so the curve looks like this right here. And of course, this is 1. And you don't have this right here, though. So just letting you guys know, we're not looking at this. Anyway, take a guess. What's the hyperbolic version of the cosine and hyperbolic version of the sine? Same thing. We are still going to pick a point on the curve. And for this point, yes, the x value is the hyperbolic of the cosine. And I will just write it as cosine and then the h after that. And you can say as hyperbolic cosine or cosh. It's like your friend Josh, but it's with a c now, so cosh. And now, what is the input? It's the input still the angle from here to rotate to there. No, not really. But the picture is the following. So here we go. Starting from the positive x-axis up to here, and I will still connect here to this point. This time, the input is actually not this angle, but rather the area of this region right here divided by 2. So right here, if I put the input to be t, this right here, this area, is precisely just t over 2, right? So in other words, this input is twice as big as this area. And let me finish the rest for you guys first, and then I will tell you guys, well, let's look back to see if there is a connection or not. Well, hyperbolic cosine is the x value. Of course, the hyperbolic sine, and I'll just write it as S-I-N-H. And the way to say it is just sinh, or if you would like, hyperbolic sine. That's fine too. And the input is also T like this, right? So that's pretty much it. Now let's come back to here to see if this actually makes sense or not. Earlier I told you this T is the angle, but it was the traditional way to do the trig functions. But the beauty is that, in fact, this area right here, it's also T over 2. And let me just show you guys that real quick, and I will just erase that, and I'll just do the work right here for you guys. Suppose you have a circle, and of course, let's just say the radius is equal to 1, and of course, we know the area of the whole circle is just pi times 1 squared, which is just pi, right? Area of the unit circle. Perfect. But this time, I don't want the whole circle. So what we do is, I just want a sector. So I want just like this part maybe, and this time I will use theta. Now, the area of the sector, so I'll just indicate that right here. This right here, it depends on how big this angle is, because this is just a portion of the whole circle. So I will have to look at the angle theta in radians and divide it by 2 pi. And of course, the whole circle is pi, so you multiply by pi. And as you can see, pi cancel out, so the area of this sector is just precisely theta over 2. And earlier, I just used t, so of course, this right here is just t over 2. And this is the beauty. If you look at the area of this sector and divide it by 2, you see, the input here, this t here, is precisely twice as big as this area, likewise sine t as well. So we look at areas, not angles. Okay, so that's pretty much it. And earlier I wrote this down by erase, but I'll put it back real quick. Right? This is just from that and that. Based on this, in fact, we can come up with an identity real quick as well. This is x, that's y. So we know I can write it as cosh squared t and then minus sinh squared t. And this right here equals to 1. Okay, so this is cool, this is nice, but I can do better than that because we have more things to talk about. First of all, when we have cosh of whatever the input is, so I just write down cosh t. This right here is in fact the combination of two exponential functions. Namely, we have e to the t, and then we add it with e to the negative t, but you divide it by 2. And in fact, cosh is what we call the even part of e to the t, and maybe later on we'll do more videos on that. And similarly, sinh, it's actually just the subtraction. So you have e to the t minus e to the negative t all over 2, right? So this two right here, I'll just tell you, this is the connection between the hyperbolic functions and the exponential functions.